What was so wonderful about the first time we came here is we went through a lot of plates and just made a lot of different things. And it was so exciting then because I just wanted to do another one and try something else. So making printmaking for the first time, I came to it with a lot of preconceived ideas. One of them was that printmaking is essentially a drawing medium. And I know this isn't true. I know it's become even more clear that prints can be many, many kinds of things. And I primarily make paintings with a brush, and I make watercolors. And I wasn't quite sure how printmaking would work because I thought that printmaking is something that requires an enormous discipline. It requires a lot of careful pre-planning and planning in order to make a print, and I wasn't sure that I would actually take to it. And one of the things that was so exciting about coming to the press was this sense of total experimentation. There was this thrill in just picking up a different tool and seeing what it would do. And so it became very exciting for me to experiment using different tools in a way that's completely different for me as a painter. After our first experience, I knew that I wanted to do something that was really very different than what I do in my own painting. So I was aware that I wanted just to work with the printing more like as in a way that was sort of counter to what I've been doing in a painting. So that meant for this last time not using aquatint, not using something that I would apply with a brush. And I found that there's all these things that happen in printmaking that I just can't foresee, and that's really exciting. That there's an element, I wouldn't quite call it chance, but there's an element of working on the plate and then printing it and then changing the plate that just takes me out of all of my rational decisions. And with printmaking, the first thing I'm presented with is this shiny copper plate. That is, you know, I'm seeing the reflections of the room in it and everything like that, and it's almost a non-material for me because I realize if I'm looking at it the way I would as a painter, that copper plate would become the ground for all of the color that was then going to be applied to it. And in this case, it's the finished print has nothing to do with that copper plate. But this is the beauty of printmaking. It has everything to do with that plate.